All right, so this is a test of this amp. Right now, there are no tubes in the amp, okay? There's no tubes. The power has been on for over an hour. It's been well over an hour. It's pushing maybe an hour and a half to 2 hours, okay? Because I timed it as 20, so I know it was past 20 minutes, and that was a long time ago. So, what I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna try to play the amp through the play the guitar through the amp, even though that there's no tube, so I don't expect any sound. I don't know what's causing this to trip the fuses, so I'm gonna try with the guitar to see if it trips out with the different, volume settings. Even though we may not hear anything, it may still cause the fuse to trip, to die. And I have only a few more fuses after that because I think I only bought five. I didn't think I was gonna need all of those five. Then, if it doesn't pop, then I'm going to add one fuse at a time until it does pop. Now, I might not do them all in one video right now, but this is the first attempt with no fuses, with no not fuses, with no tubes in the compute amp. They're in the back, okay? They're sitting in the back, and I'm going to make sure that they go in the correct order. They were in the correct order that I could tell, but I'm just going to confirm and make sure that every tube goes into the correct socket. And what I think is that some of the tubes are blown, but I don't know how a blown tube would make the amp fuse blow. That part I don't understand. So here's the first attempt of me trying to plug the guitar in with no tubes. And usually it makes a sound that I don't always pay attention to the sound, but it makes a sound before the fuse pops. So I'm going to pay attention this time. Matter of fact, I'm going to actually close the garage just to make sure that there is no outside noise, dog barking or car passing by. So I'm just gonna plug into the amp right now. I don't have a way to time this to say how long does it take before it shorts out, but we're gonna plug in right now, and I'm at 314, 315 in the video. So I have it on standby, and I think that the problem is going to start after I take it off of standby. All right, here we go. I'm going to take it off of standby. I don't hear anything. I think I heard something before it popped the last time. So right now, as I expected, you can't hear anything, right? Because there's no tubes in there. So the volume is haven't changed. So the volume is set to where it was before. So I don't think the volume is the issue. But I didn't change the volume from the last time it popped. I don't expect any sound now. I'm just trying to do a process of elimination. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn the amp off. I'm gonna put in the first tube in the first slot, but I have to turn the amp off in order to discharge the electricity. I'm not gonna make no moves unless the power is unplugged. That's probably what the standby switch is for, but I'm not gonna take any chances. All right, so it's unplugged, and then I'm going to make sure that the tubes go back in the correct order. I can't tell if the tubes are busted or not by looking at them. I mean, that one could be busted, but I don't know what a good one's supposed to look like. It looks like something is not connected on the first one, but I can't go by that. There's no way that I can know which two is busted and which one is not. Okay, so the first one would be a 7025. And this one is a, well, there go the issue right there. From, let me see, making sure we go from left to right. A 12AT7. So that could be the issue right there, that these tubes are not in the correct position. I took them out in the correct position, but that could be the issue, is that they have certain numbers, and the numbers are not lining up, and that could be the issue. That could be the problem. It was never set up right in the first place. Because the first fuse, I keep calling these fuses. The first tube is supposed to be 7025. Second one is supposed to be 7025. The third one is supposed to be 7025. Fourth one, 7025, 7025. So it's only supposed to be 12A77s. And it looks like all the rest of these are the 12AX7s. So that could be the issue. They don't have the right tubes in the socket. They're not matching. So that could be the problem. These are all 12AT7s. And there's only one. Nope, they're all the same. I'm trying to keep them in order, the order that I took them out. T7, X7s. 7025. So I don't know if that's the issue or not, okay? What I'm doing is I'm looking at what the factory said. And I will bet the reason why it's having an issue is because the wrong tubes are in the slot. 12, and I could be wrong, it may not make a difference. Groove tube, G2. So this is a GT12AT7. Okay, so it's only supposed to be two of those. And if we go from left to right, it's supposed to be only on one, and one, two, three, four, five. One and five is supposed to be
this. Let me see if it was. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, okay. So far. Yeah. So that was correct. Yeah. Now, let me look at the last two on the end. That's what we're supposed to have is 7025. And these are not that. And I'm thinking 7025s. I'm missing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 7025s.
Alright, so now I can bring this the camera over to you so you can see what's going on. 7025s. Okay, can I turn this or no? I think I told it that I can't turn it around. I think I made that mistake. Okay, so I'm going to try to point it here. So here they are. Maybe you can see what I'm doing or maybe you can't. So number one is supposed to be that particular, let's call it model. And then number 5 is supposed to be that model. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But the rest of them are supposed to be something else. They're supposed to be 7025s. And what they are 12AX7Cs. Now, I don't know the difference between the 7025s and these, but what if it's the wrong rating, and that's what's making the fuses blow. Since I replaced these are the new ones, it caused the strain over here. In other words, I got this side working, the two main ones working, but what if it's causing these to blow because it's working properly now? I know, I'm not sure. So that's the issue, is that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of these are not rated to where it's supposed to be rated. They're not the correct replacement. And I don't know if it makes a difference or not. Maybe it doesn't make a difference. Maybe it does. So it bothers me that you have 5 that are not the right model. I'm not talking about the brand. I'm talking about the actual number that's on the two doesn't match. So I don't know what is replaceable. So I'm going to have to look it up to see which other models numbers are acceptable. So I don't want to put these back into the tube knowing that they're wrong. I mean, I can put number 1 and 5 in, and maybe I can do that right now. I'll put 1 and 5 in and see if that causes a problem. I should just do one from left to right. I'll do 1. And then I'll do 5. I'll do that now, just as a process of elimination. But I may have gotten to the bottom of it. It had the wrong series tubes in it. All right, so let's try that. So we're going to try. I'm not going to put the main tubes in yet. Okay. Because the main tubes could be causing it to pop. So we're going to put the number 1 in. Once I get the right orientation. Okay, so there it is. All right, so number 1 is in. I'm not going to cover them yet. Number 1 is in. I'm going to turn it off. I'm going to plug it up. I don't expect any sound. So number one fuse from left to right, not the main ones, not the two main ones, but the small ones. Power is on. I'm not trying to play it, so I'm gonna take it off of standby. No sound, using only the first channel. The amp is not making any noise. I'm gonna give it a second. I'm turning the volume of the mic, of the guitar up to see what happens internally, right? It might not play it out, but it may have an internal issue. So I don't know how long it takes for it to go out, but I will assume at this point that one tube is not gonna cause it. It's not gonna make the fuse blow until we actually hear a sound, and that's probably gonna come from putting the main tubes in. Okay, so discharge on deck, standby. And I'm gonna turn it off. Now I'm gonna include tube number five. I'm gonna include tube number five because it's the correct model. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm gonna put this one in. Position number five. I don't know if these two are blown or not blown or what. So far we have two small ones in only. So we're gonna plug it back up. Make sure it's turned off. Plug it back up. Turn the power on. I don't hear anything. Take it off of standby. I don't hear anything. That was on 10 on my guitar. I'm glad that didn't happen. No sound. Okay, no sound. So now I'm gonna turn it off and I'm gonna put the two main tubes in here. Hopefully you get some sound, but it won't blow the fuse. If it blows the fuse, then I'm gonna be really confused on why it's having this problem. Even though the big fuses are not the rating, also, I put those fuses in there to replace what was already in there. And see, I've already busted two fuses. All right, so the rating for the other tube, it's too dark for me to see it here, but it's, I can't see it in that light, but it's not, these are the replacement, meaning I basically swapped the old for the new ones, but these may not be the correct model also. So we're just gonna put these back in. So I suspect something is gonna happen. I'm probably gonna blow these fuses now. I mean, not fuse, yeah, the fuse. I'm probably gonna blow the fuse. So I have the two main tubes in, and I have tube number 1 and 5. If this doesn't work, I'm not going to take the chance to put the wrong tube in. I'll just take it to a shop, or I'll just order the right tubes and go from there and do another process of elimination. It's a lot of work, but you know, it's better than spending $200 or $300 to get it repaired when the only thing that the repair person gonna do is put the correct tubes model numbers in there, right? So here we go. Turn it on. And then I can see that one is getting lit up, right? One is getting lit up, which is from my left to right. Number 2 is getting lit up. One and two. Now, it's on standby, so I'm gonna take it off of standby. Okay, so now you could tell that it's gonna have some audio, or I can hear it. Okay, so you don't hear it through the amp, but you can tell it's on after I put it on standby, because it's that clicking sound, that deep clicking sound. So I only have one. It's getting louder and louder. I think it's gonna blow. Yeah, it's gonna blow, because it got louder and louder and then it popped. Yeah, I'm gonna stop it. It gets louder and louder with that hum, and then it pops. So the only thing that's gonna happen is it's gonna blow another fuse, but I have a funny feeling it's about to do that. And that one of the tubes is not lighting up. I'm really scared. I don't want it to do something that I'm not anticipating, right? So I know I have volume and I didn't hear it. So it doesn't have all the other fuses. Excuse me, it doesn't have all the other tubes to make it have a sound. But that hum getting louder and louder and louder and louder, that is what happened right before the fuse blew. So we're just gonna try it this time. I'm gonna just bear with it, and let me see if I can, if the fuse will pop without hearing the sound. So I'm gonna turn it back on, take it off of standby. It's quiet right now. It's quiet. Only one of the main fuses. Excuse me, I keep calling them fuses. Now it's starting to hum. Only one of the main fuses, tubes is lit up. Now it's starting to get louder, that hum. I've never been on this side when it blew. That's what I said, I was scared. I've never been on this side. Yeah, it's clicking. Oh shit, I don't like the way that sounds. No, that's too much. That's too much. There's something wrong with this thing. I don't like that. It's getting louder and louder and louder and louder. Yeah. So when we deal with electricity, I don't play with electricity. Something is wrong. And it could be dealing with those two main tubes. And I have a sneaky suspicion that they're the wrong tubes, even though I replaced them.
they should have never been in the amp to begin with. Now, only two is getting hot, and one is not getting hot. See, so two is hot, one is not. I don't know what that means, right? So I would rather just take it to a shop that knows what they're doing. They can tell me, hey, this is gone, this is blown, this is a problem, versus me, you know, taking the chance. An honest shop can tell me exactly what's going on from experience, right? But they can also replace the correct tubes without me putting the bad tubes in the slots where it's not correctly rated. And these tubes that I purchased, the new ones, even though the amp did work, they could be the wrong rating for this amp, and that's why it's making that noise, and it gets higher and higher and higher, and then eventually the fuse is just going to pop. So something about a regulator. So maybe the regulator for this has stopped working. So it's just going to build and build and build and build and build and build and then pop, regardless if I'm playing the guitar. Playing the guitar probably had nothing to do with it. Playing sound through the amp probably had nothing to do with it. So at this point, I'm going to go on the side of caution. I'm just going to have a professional look at it. And the solution could be just replacing the proper tubes, meaning the tubes always had the wrong model tubes in them. And then when I replaced exactly what was in there, and I still have the original to prove it, that they were the exact same, it was the exact same model that I took out. I never got rid of the old one. In other words, let somebody who's, you know, experienced at this deal with this, and I just have to pay for that service and then get my other amp service also. But yeah, I don't like that building up. I don't know what could happen. A fire could start. Anything bad could happen, you know, when it's doing that. And I'm not going to take the chance to catch fire, or, you know, which is a possibility, or damage the amp any more than it needs to be damaged, right? I wasn't doing anything to make the amp damage. All I did is turn it on. And then it was playing perfectly. There was nothing wrong. And then all of a sudden, it just cut off by itself. I wasn't even playing no guitar through it. So that building, I don't know what that means. I don't know if that means that the main tubes are messed up, right? The new ones. I don't know if that means that the old tubes are messed up. I don't know if it's an internal issue. It can't be an electricity issue, because I tried it in three different places, a whole different building here and then inside the studio. All three can't be messed up. All three locations, electricity cannot be messed up. So I don't think it's the electricity going into the amp. It could be just age. The amp bit it. It basically, whatever regulates the power probably died. And hopefully it doesn't cost too much to replace or to repair it at this point. So I made this video so you know that, you know, the amp will turn on because the fuse is good, but if it tries to play, it's going to pop. And I don't know if it's because it's the electricity, or if it's a regulator that no longer works, or if it's the main fuses, or if it's the two that I put in there, the one and the five. But it's leaning toward those two main tubes. Something is not right. It probably was the wrong rating for this amp. Who knows? But I'll find out.
All right, bro. Sorry about this, man. It is what it is.